Nick Smith is live at Chicago's O'Hare International Airport. We're just all over airports today. About 30% of people are traveling for the holidays by air, Nick. Is that right?
A lot of 30% traveling by air, and Adrian, a lot of those traveling by air need to be aware of what Gerard was just talking about earlier, that there is a weather system moving through next week that could affect things. And being prepared, Jen, you and I were talking about this, is about more than simply wearing a mask to the airport. It's about being prepared on all fronts.
That's correct. Bring your proper ID. People always show up without ID. There's always one person at the front who's just waiting there making the line longer. So be prepared with that. Be prepared to have your liquids and your electronics out of your suitcase. Just everything you would typically do for a flight, make sure you're doing it as early as you possibly can.
And Jennifer, I don't want to call anybody out, but over our shoulder, we see people checking in right now. Why are people still waiting till they get to the airport?
Because they're not prepared. You can check in for your flight 24 hours in advance on the airline website or on their app. And I highly recommend it. You won't have to wait in the line, which we've seen all morning has been fluctuating, even up to an hour wait. You'll just be able to check your bag if you need to, which you probably shouldn't because it's not efficient, and then get in the security line.
You and your team have been writing and talking about this extensively. You've also been talking about the fact that people usually plan their trips months in advance, international, domestic. They need to pay closer attention to those trips.
That's absolutely right. If you've planned your trip far in advance, it's likely that the details have changed. Either your flight has changed or the country requirements have changed. You may not be able to get in. So it's best to go to the U.S. Embassy website of the country or city that you're going to see what their current requirements are and see whether you're allowed to get in, whether you need a test or anything like that.
Because all of that can change by the hour.
Absolutely. There are countries even now that are shutting down again, like Austria and Iceland might be soon, and Japan is still closed, so.
And Jen, you and I were talking about, the other thing we were talking about is how TSA, even though they've opened up more lines, we still need to be prepared to possibly wait a little bit longer than we would ordinarily.
That's correct, yeah, the lines are changing all the time. There's so many people traveling, about 54 million people coming through, so make sure you leave enough time for all the other people who are traveling at the same time you are.
Jennifer, thank you so much. Adrian, I'm going to tell you, I had a chance to speak to a couple of families earlier. The responses may surprise you, and I'm excited to share that with you in the next hour.
What was the question? We don't have to tell us the responses now, but what was the question?
The question was, are y'all ready, and why are you running up here in the last minute? And I just asked it straight up, and you'll be surprised.
You were Uncle Nick this morning. Okay.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. As long as you weren't Scrooge or the Grinch, we're okay with that. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.